Hi there, my name is Christina Halstead, and this is a tutorial video for Toon Boom Harmony Essentials. What I'm going to talk about here is the toolbars and a little bit about the settings. Well, last time I talked about moving the modules around, and now I want to talk about a second part of the modules, which is just as important, and that's the toolbars. And you can see toolbars are all over the place. What's nice about this, like I mentioned before, the modules, is that you can really move these toolbars around and put them wherever you want them to. So you got different, most of the sections are either to the side or above and below any particular window. So right here, we've got about six or seven toolbars up here. We can actually drag and drop them all around this outside window. As you can see, I just pick it up by the little silver bar and can drag and drop them. You also have them inside these windows. Now, inside each window, usually there's a specific toolbar that pertains to only that window. And you can also add in toolbars that you can find in other places. You can do this by right-clicking on any of the gray areas. You'll see right now that I have camera view. That toolbar is right here. And I can also, if I want to, move the deformation. Let's go ahead and just move the, actually, no, I'll move the playback. Right now, the playback is up here in the main toolbar area. I can go ahead and click that, and now it's in my camera view. I can drag it to the side, to the bottom, and to the other side, but I can't actually drag it back into the main area. If I want to do that, I have to tell it to go back by right-clicking on the main area. If you want to, other bars, some bars don't show up initially. So let's say, I believe the timeline, yep, the timeline's missing its bar. So I can go ahead and right click, and you'll see that there's no check mark next to the timeline view. So if I'll go ahead and click that, and the timeline specific toolbar will show up. Each toolbar can be modified. You can actually customize all of them except the main toolbar right here that has all of your general tools for using Toon Boom. I'm going to put that actually back over here. I like it over here. So for instance, the form toolbar, if I right click on it, I can go to customize. In this case, as far as tools, all the four tools that it has for it are already displayed. These little sprockets are all scripts, except for the one little flash thing right there. Let's go to one that we can actually modify. Let's go to the camera view here. If I go to customize, you can see that on the left side, we have tools that are not yet in that toolbar. If we want to move tools over to that toolbar, we just simply click on the tool and use a little arrow to move it over. Once it's over here, you can actually use an up and down arrows to put it in whatever order you wish it to be. So now that delete option is now in my toolbar. Another thing you might notice right now is that I've got this little red box is showing up on the outside of each window when I roll over that window. That's actually something that is not usually on when you first start Toon Boom. I'll show you how to get to that, and I'll show you what it is. In here is preferences in the edit dropdown, and in the general area, the general tab, I should say, you'll see that this right here, focus on mouse enter, is what I have selected. I'll go ahead and turn that off so you can see the difference. The red box generally is an indicator of what area, what window you're currently in. And in order, in this case, for the red box to show up, I have to actively click on that. If you want, you can set up focus on mouse enter, which basically automates that to wherever your mouse is. It's pretty useful if you have your keyboard commands and you want to just use it in that specific window. You just have to leave your mouse on that, tap on your keyboard, and then it'll do whatever it wants to do in that specific window. It won't affect any other window but the window you're in. And that can be, that's really good for expediting if you're doing your stop motion animation, or if you're going through your traditional hand-drawn animation, knowing your hotkeys and then using them in the proper window can really speed up your work. And that's pretty much it for a few of the settings and the toolbars.